It's Sunday, January 24th, and we are at my Aunt Bertha's 100th birthday party. So, here we go, I'll show you around.
One of the twins.
How are you guys doing?
Hi.
You're on camera?
Are we on movies?
Yeah.
Is this what you take your videos with all the time?
Yeah.
On your website?
This little thing right here. So, wanted Gene to see this, so.
Oh, okay, great.
Is Aunt Bertha here?
Yeah, she's right beside you, right there, in that wheelchair.
There's Aunt Bertha. Okay, got a time down.
Bill Gretzinger through his sister at gospel camp. They wrote, met, and married, settled in South Dakota, farmed for 25 years, South Saskatchewan. This is my mom's writing, so. They farmed there for 25 years. Bill was a welder for General Motors, started his own shop, John Deere Ford dealer, sold out, and after two trips around the U.S., came to Lodi. Marilyn was born in 28, and Eleanor was born in 30, and the twins were born in April 2nd, 1951. So they came to Lodi with six-month-old twins. She was active in Tops, the Grange, mostly in this church, taught five Sabbath schools, and ran many social events. She sold her house in Church Street and lived at Arbor several years, and Marilyn. Okay, now resides in Vienna. Visitors are always welcome. Got kind of an informal thing going on. We do want to ask if anybody has any stories and that kind of thing to tell throughout the afternoon. You want to just come up, grab a microphone, and just tell your story. But what we'd like to do right now is have a little blessing of this event.
Aunt Bertha, you are truly an amazing lady, and I can't help but think that if my mother had lived, the two of you would be celebrating today. Since you were both born the same month and year, and you both had a set of twin boys as your last children, at a time when you weren't so young. I'm sure you exchanged many thoughts on raising boys, or maybe you cried on each other's shoulders. You've been a great historian to me, telling me who is related to who and about your childhood. Your children and grandchildren can learn much from you. I read an article about old times recently, and I want to quote some of it for you. There is so much to be gained from older people in our lives. They have been there, done that, as we would say today. Far too often, though, especially in the Western culture, we discount the value of the elderly. We tend to push them off to the side as we try to live our busy lives, not realizing the value of their years. We dishonor them when we do that. Just to hear the stories of the past and how people lived and got along is a blessing in itself, and the wealth of the wisdom is there. The Lord speaks of these things in His Word, and I'd like to share a couple of verses. One of my favorites says, "Rise in the presence of the aged, show respect for the elders, and reverence your God. I am the Lord." That's found in Leviticus. What the verse says seems to be lost these days, but God says to rise in the presence of the elderly and give them respect. If someone is elder to you, always rise to greet him or her each time you meet them. It even honors God.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
cooperative plan.
Still has a son.